In Jesus' name. Father, we worship you. He was here that Ayatoru kilo le she Allahu mi kilo le she talo jula Allahu mi talo jula talo jula Allahu mi talo jula. Resident in this ministry and this commission, it is grace. In the name of the Lord. One thing I have studied. You know, there is a time you sit down and decide to study. What you notice follows a ministry. I can tell you it's grace. We enter into nations, my great man of God, very cheaply. We don't even struggle. We don't struggle, we don't even do, we just walk into certain nations and take over those nations. I pray from my heart for you. May you live here with a greater grace. 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 Live here with a greater grace. In the name of Jesus. It is done. In Jesus' name. Let's give the Lord a big hand as we take our seat. Awesome. Everyone who came in maybe late last night or came at any other time, please, it is very important that you get the meat, the tapes, the materials from the first night. From the first morning, rather. Yesterday morning, get the materials. You had two sessions yesterday. Please, it's very important because a lot of things have been shared, a lot of things have been considered. And I believe, God, that most times when you keep hearing something, it becomes a part of your spirit. When you get the materials, the tapes, and you keep hearing them, it becomes a part of you, a part of your spirit. And whatever becomes a part of your spirit automatically becomes a part of your life. Am I speaking to somebody? If something becomes a part of your spirit, that thing becomes a part of your life in the name of the Lord Jesus. I want us to consider 1 Kings chapter 13. I'll run through several scriptures, several verses, maybe to verse 10, and that's why we can just be patient. Or let me get to 1 Kings chapter 13. I'll read verse 1, I'll just call the verses I'm going to be reading out. So when I mention that verse, you fix your eyes on it. 1 Kings chapter 13, verse 1 says, "And behold, there came a man of God out of Judah by the word of the Lord unto Bethel. And Jeroboam stood by the altar to burn incense." Move over to verse 4. "And it came to pass when King Jeroboam had the saying of the old of the man of God, which had cried against the altar in Bethel, that he put forth his hand by the altar, saying, Lay hold on him. And his hand which he put forth against him dried up, so that he could not pull it again to him. Verse 7, "And the king said unto the man of God, Come home with me, refresh thyself, I will give thee reward. And the man of God said unto the king, If thou would give me half thy house, I will not go in with thee, neither will I eat bread nor drink water in this place. For it was charged me by the word of the Lord, saying, Eat no bread nor drink no water, and by the same way that thou camest." Verse 11, "There was an old prophet in Bethel, and his sons came and told him." He was an old prophet, but he still had sons. So many old prophets still have sons. "And told him all the works that the man of God had done that day in Bethel, the words which he had spoken unto the king, them they also told to their father. Their father said, Where went he? For the sons had seen what way the man of God went, which came from Judah." Move over to 14. "And went after the man of God, found him sitting on an oak, said unto him, Art thou the man of God that camest from Judah? He answered, I am. He said, Come with me and eat bread. Verse 16, he answered, I may not return with thee, nor go in with thee, neither will I eat bread nor drink water with thee in this place. For it was said to me by the word of the Lord, Thou shalt eat no bread, nor drink water, nor turn again, or go by the way which thou camest. He said unto him, I am a prophet also as thou art, and an angel speak unto me by the word of the Lord, saying, Bring him back with thee that into the house, that he may eat bread and drink water. But he lied. So he went back with him and did eat bread in his house and drank water. It came to pass, as they sat at the table, the word of the Lord came unto the prophet that brought him back." Not an angel this time. It was now the word came. "And he cried unto the man of God, say, that came from Judah, saying, Thus saith the Lord, For as much as thou hast disobeyed the mouth of the Lord, and hast not kept the commandment which the Lord thy God commanded thee." Verse 20. When he was gone, a lion met him by the way, slew him, and his carcass was cast in the way, and the ass stood by it. The lion also stood by the carcass. And behold, men passed by and saw the carcass cast in the way, and the lion standing by the carcass. They came and told it in the city where the old prophet dwelt. When the old prophet that brought him back from the way heard thereof, he said, If it is the man of God who was disobedient unto the word of the Lord, therefore the Lord had delivered him to the lion, which had torn him and slain him, and according to the word of the Lord which he spake. Verse 30. And he laid his carcass in his own grave, and they mourned over him, saying, Alas, my brother." Now, if you read verse 30, I want you to read it again. You see, and he laid, it was the old prophet now. Are you listening? Who brought the young prophet? He laid the carcass in his own grave. He laid the carcass in his own grave. He was living but dead. A man who was alive, God already said he had a grave. He laid the carcass in his own grave. He died long ago but had not expired. So this time he had to make a young man both die and expire. So very shortly, I want to share on costly diversion. Expensive diversion. Diversions that are costly. Amen. Costly diversion. There are people who say to themselves, God has given me a mandate. God has given me an assignment. God has sent me to take over the world. And it is true, they heard God. There are people who say, God spoke to me, I had this voice. People came and they confirmed what God said. That God said, I will take over America. God said, I will take over Europe. God said, over Africa, over Asia, North and South America. God said, I'm going to take over those places. And it is true that God spoke. It is true that they heard from God that they have just stepped into a new level of ministry. The healing ministry, they just stepped into the prophetic ministry, an anointing had just come upon them. It is true. It is God that spoke. God has spoke that the key of their nation, he put it practically in their hand. Whether you like it or not, there are certain people that hold the key to some nations. There is nothing you can do. God made it so. There are some gatekeepers. There are some city takers. God made it so. They just found favor before God, and God made it so. So God has spoken to these people, spoken to you, given you a word, and said, this is what you are going to become. It is true. But I want you to understand that no matter how many prophecies are on your head, no matter the commission on your life, no matter what God has said about you, God can change his mind. God can say, I said it before, I don't say it again. Psalm 115 verse 3, the Bible says, our God is in the heavens and he doeth as he pleases. You can't question him. I said so before, but this time I have changed my mind. I said I'm going to give you the world. He spoke to Eli in 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 30. He said, Eli, how would you kick against my sacrifice? And he spoke angrily. He said, I will cut off the arm of your father's house from Israel. He said, there will be no man to grow old in thy kindred. So God released and imposed premature death in the lineage of Eli. His son died. His two sons died in one day. But this was the same Eli that God says, there will not lack a man from your gene to sit on the throne. In other words, Eli, you have become a king. Your children, your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren, all of them are going to be kings. Eli, you are a progenitor. You have become a progenitor of rulership. Eli, you have become a king. So everyone after you are going to be kings. But when the sons of Eli tempered with the vessels of God, God said, now I change my mind. You can't call him a liar. He changed his mind. He's supreme. You see, I changed my mind. Am I speaking to somebody here? One time, David offended the Lord, and the Lord promised a judgment upon David. David took a sacrifice, and God said, I will not bring it in your day, but I'll bring it in the day of your sons. Hezekiah was about to die. A prophetic word came. Put your house in order. Thou shalt surely die. And the Bible says Hezekiah turned his face to the wall and said, God, the dead can't praise you. Only the living can praise you. It was praise that made God change his mind concerning Hezekiah, not the wall. It was what he said. The dead can praise you. And God added 15 more years. I was somewhere and somebody said 15 years was too small. And it was just too small. I said 15 years is not too small to a dying man. Number one. Number two, if he gets to 14 years, if I'm him, I will turn and face the wall again and repeat the same thing I said before. And God add 15 more. When he gets to 14, I face that same wall again. I said the same thing. And God give me 15 in fivefold. That's 75. You add 75 to his initial 60, 70. So he will leave this world at 130 something. And I think that's long life. Am I speaking to somebody here? So study your Bible. The place we read from. Watch me. The Bible said, there came a man of God. Look at the definition. It said, from Judah, by the word of the Lord to Bethel. There came a man of God. Now look at the definition of who a man of God is. From Judah, with the word of the Lord, unto Bethel. What a definition of who a man of God is. So a man of God is not necessarily a pastor. A man of God from Judah, with the word of the Lord unto Bethel. These three things define a man of God. What is Judah? Praises to God. The word of the Lord. What is Bethel? The presence of God. So the man of God is one that understands that praises belongs to God. Everything that happens to him belongs to God. He has the word of the Lord and continually stays in the presence of the Lord. That is who a man of God is. A man of God is one who continually, by his life, by his action, by his words, by his deed, ascribes honor to God, and he has the word of God in his mouth, and is continually in the presence of the Lord. The man of God from Judah with the word of the Lord came to Bethel. So these are the, you cannot surround yourself with these three dynamites and fail. Praises to God by your life, by your action. You are an addict of God's word. Am I talking to somebody? You get drunk, ladies and gentlemen, get drunk with God's word. Get drunk. I didn't just say drink, I say get drunk. Have you seen a drunken man? When a man is drunk and is really drunk, he is said to be under the influence of something, of alcohol, of nicotine, under the influence of something. And when you say somebody is under the influence, it means it is the thing that now controls him. You didn't get me? When a man is under the influence of alcohol, it doesn't mean that he has taken alcohol. It means alcohol has taken him. He has not taken it in. It has now taken him. Under the influence of alcohol. It doesn't mean he has taken alcohol. It means alcohol has taken him. He's now being controlled by alcohol. So you are going to get drunk with God's word. And the man of God is a man with the word and a man of God's presence. Now watch this. He said, as soon as God sent him, he said he cried against the altar. And as he cried against the altar, there was a reaction. And the reaction came from the king. And the king said, smite him. And he stretched his hand, and on the spot it dried up. Number one, when God sends you, he backs you. When God sends you, he backs you. If God sends a man, he will back up that man. I don't know the challenge you are going through. If you are not being backed up, it might mean you are not being sent. Scriptures cannot be broken. Whatever attempts to break the unbreakable will break. Whatever attempts to break the unbreakable will break. Scriptures can be broken. If God sends you, he backs you. This land where we are now, this church land we are now, is a disputed land between two communities. This place is called Auchi. If you cross the road, it's called Jetu. For over 100 years, they were fighting for this land. Who owned the land? So the land was a sacred, like they say, there are some place they call Evil Forest. Sacred. What's it called? Sacred land. Don't go there. For years, it was so. So one time, God spoke to me. And I was telling God, I need, and God spoke to me, said, son, that what the assignment I'm giving you is not a localized assignment. It's an international work. It has to be strategized on an express road. I said, Lord, I don't know where. I don't have land. And God said, just take a walk. When I got close some in the evening to somewhere around this place, the Holy Spirit said to me, this is the place. And I went to meet an elder. And I asked him, I said, look at. He called me in. He said, do you want to die? I said, why? He said, no, do you want to die? I had just gotten married then. He said, you know why I enjoy your wife? You won't die. I said, as how? He said, the land that two kings left. Do you know how many people have died there? You want to go? Ladies and gentlemen, my heartbeat skip. I went back to God. I said, Father, they say people have died. They said, that's why I'm sending you so that people won't die again. I said, okay. I went, began to pray. One evening, God said, I should come. I waited till almost to one. God said, go there. I said, eh? No light. Take a lantern and torch. I came with lantern and torch. As soon as I came, I saw owl. You know owl? OW12. They spread. You know this owl? They look very ugly with big eyes. That's they're looking at me. I was praying. And I was praying. They spread their wings and they were walking gradually towards me. Together, like the riyas, they marched past. Walking together. I was standing and God said to me, This is what will decide who owns the land. If you run, you lose it. If you stay, there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the more I'm binding, the more they are coming close. The more I'm binding, the more they are coming close. So I just shut my eyes. That is when you start speaking in tongues. When you speak in tongues, you generate something inside you. Am I speaking here? Now, when you speak in tongues, it's no longer you talking. The Holy Ghost has taken over. I held my anointing oil and I just began to pray in the Holy Ghost. As I was praying the Holy Ghost, something said to me, when Goliath ran to David, David ran to Goliath. So I took steps. They were coming. I took steps and they began to move backwards. Am I talking to somebody right now? Today, the rest is history. Am I speaking to somebody here? And my, let me shock you. My town, they are busy rejoicing. They thank God. It has been proven that the land belongs to us. I say, it doesn't belong to you. The land belongs to the Lord. I'm not in Auchi. I'm not in Jetu. I'm on Abuja Expressway. Am I speaking to somebody right now? Tell somebody, God will back you up. Say, God will back you up. But there was no backup until he cried against evil. It was not a part of what he met on the land. Sit down. Pastor. That a diabolic or a wrong practice has been in existence for long doesn't make it right. That the lie has been in office for a long time doesn't make it the truth. Longevity is not legality. That an error has been perpetrated for a long time does not make it right. When you meet what does not align to scriptures, correct it. I was with a man of God, popular man of God, very popular, and we sat somewhere and there was something he said and I said, I'm sorry, I don't do that. He said, what is wrong with you? When did you start preaching? Well, we've been preaching for a long time. I said, sir, with all due respect, I don't do that. He said, really? I said, I don't do that. And I never talked to him till we landed. I helped him when he came on the plane. I helped him to carry his briefcase. Elderly man. I helped to carry his briefcase and everything. When we landed, I left him to carry his briefcase himself. I carried mine and I walked away. Have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness. I said, when you start preaching, what are you talking about? I said, I'm sorry, sir. I don't do that. You must cry to get God's backing. You must cry against evil. Don't think that Satan will spare you when you react against evil. God's choice is the devil's target. When you are the choice of God, you become the target of the devil. When you choose to be different from others, you refuse to join your brothers, you know, to commit the things they commit, like the brothers of Joseph. When you refuse to join them, they will label you, they will brand you and give you a name. When you choose to be different, they will call you names. When you choose not to do what they do, even in a circle that people think is holy, and some people are perpetrating unrighteousness, when you choose to be different, you choose to take a stand, they will call you names. They will say you are trying to prove you are too much, you are trying to prove holier than thou. But you must take a stand to be outstanding. Am I speaking to somebody now? You must take a stand to be outstanding. Somebody started a wrong life, someone has to start a true life. In the days of Apostle Babalola, the days of our founding fathers, I discover you enter some churches, you see women on one spot, men on one area. No matter how you call them local and outdated, power was raw. I was reading the episode of Apostle Babalola, his life and times, and I asked someone a question. I said, I know the writer of this book will not lie, but I'm confused. When you see account of miracles, account, they will say 46 blind, 38 lame. I will clean my eyes. I say, are they seeing 46 people with eye problem, eye pain, or blind? They say 19, sir. Raw miracles, they will say 19 protracted pregnancy, 18 women who have been carrying pregnancies for 12 years. giving birth, all of them giving birth in one night.
Why?
Anywhere holiness is exalted, power manifests naturally. Number two. Hello.
The same king
in verse 7 that stretched his hand. Please look at this. The same king that stretched his hand in verse 7 and said, kill him! Kill him! As soon as the king experienced the judgment of God, the Bible said, the same king said to him, please come to my house. Come and eat. Man of God, it was the same king who ordered he should be killed that stretched his hand to say, come and eat. When an enemy suddenly becomes a friend, watch out. Watch out. When an enemy suddenly becomes a friend, watch out. Becomes too nice all of a sudden. Too nice. Watch out. A young pastor said to me, my landlord was against me. All of a sudden, he called me. He said, Papa, your prayer is working. I said, what happened? He said, my landlord called me that he has given me the warehouse free. I should be using it. He even told me he's going to buy chairs. He even told me that he will give me some money every month. This was a landlord that would not want to see him. And he said, what do I do? I said, don't take it. Watch out. Let's pray and ask the Lord. Because there are some offers that are too good to be true. There are some airlines that are known for delay. They must delay your flight. The week they become too punctual, ask questions. It means that the upper week you are in trouble. I know a particular airline. They are very good in apology. They will always apologize for the delayed departure. One time I entered that airline, first day, second time, third time, throughout that week, they were flying on time. I called one of the captains. I said, you people have a plan. Because when the unfaithful becomes too faithful, questions should be asked. The truth is that for the next 1 or 2 weeks, we have issues with flight. So this week we are trying to make up. So that when that is happening for the next 2 weeks, people will not complain. When an enemy, you know, when Saul drew David close, David thought it was because he liked him. 1 Samuel 18:9. He said, and Saul eyed David from that day forward. Eyed. You must tell God to open your spiritual eyes to know the intentions of people. You must tell God, print people's heart on their faces. So that as I see their face, I see their heart. Print the hearts of people on their faces. So as I'm looking at their face, I'm seeing their heart. A man whose eyes are open and can see the hearts of men will not experience heartbreaking ministry. Because you will not give your heart to people who will in turn stab you in the back. Am I speaking to somebody right now? I have prayed a prayer. I say, Father, please help me. Help me, Lord, to detect rebellion 1 million miles away. I can tell you who is rebellious. I know. You don't need to show it. There are 1 or 2 things you do. I will smile. And when I smile, I have a portion in my heart. I just say this one. Mm-mm. Anything that happens tomorrow, I won't be surprised. I've met my wife. Sometimes I've said, you see this person. They are doing well, but they are not with us. She said, ah. And many of them always end up showing it. Sometimes, are you sure? I say, mm-mm. This person, from this action. A son will never react. Watch this. A young man broke a plate. The father came, shouted, screamed, rebuked him. Broke a club, a cup. The father rebuked him, said all kinds of things. The next day, the father broke the same cup. It was the son that helped him to gather without saying a statement. That's a son. You know what an hireling would have done? But was this not the same thing you were rebuking me for yesterday? The son gathered. The whole world we are seeing now came under Shem, Ham, and Japheth. The old generation came under 3 persons, but one carried a curse. Because he saw the nakedness of his father. And he went and spread it out. That's for fathers who are naked anyway. Now, what I'm trying to let us know is, I've discovered that God will only bless you on his terms, not your terms. Look up before you write something down. Look up. God was showing me the mystery of walking with God. When the prodigal son had a reconciliation with the father, the prodigal son went to a far country, the Bible says. When the reconciliation came with his father, can I shock you? The reconciliation did not come in a far country. It came in the father's land. The reconciliation was not done in the far country. It was in the father's land. God will not bless you or visit you when you have strayed. You must return to him and get reconciliation on his terms.
When an enemy
suddenly becomes a friend. Sensitivity will keep a man in check. The best gift among God, the gifts of the spirit, as far as I'm concerned, is discerning of spirits. It's not miracles, it's not healing, but discerning. When things are happening, you are discerning to confirm, test all spirits to know that which be of God. Am I speaking to somebody? He said, because Satan himself believes and trembles. He appears as the angel of light. But when God gives you a discerning heart, and that's what Solomon prayed about. Solomon said, give me a discerning heart. That give me wisdom and give me a discerning heart. So I'll be able to know what to say to he that goeth out or cometh in. Can I hear a loud amen? Number three, what did the king say to him? In verse 5, he said, come and eat. What did God tell him not to do? Don't eat. Now the king said, come and eat. Satan will always walk on your weakness. He will always walk with your weakness. Satan will walk with your weakness. Your weakness is your limitation. 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 Watch me. When did the old prophet meet him? When he was under the oak tree. I preached a message. Dangers of spiritual low percentage. Satan will always come with your weakness when you are in your days of low percentage. Under the oak tree, he was tired. Under the oak tree, he was almost frustrated. He was famished and hungry. That is when the king came, the old prophet came. The days of your spiritual low percentage are the days where you are susceptible and open to temptations.
You must be careful. Satan did not come to Jesus on the 10th, 20th, 30th day. He came on the 40th day when he was hungry. Errors and dangers of spiritual low percentage. The very day you are too weak to pray. The very day you are too weak to fast. The very day you are too weak to study the word of God. That is the period.
The devil come with ideas. The devil come and tell you, why not join this group of motivational speaking? Where you don't need to pray to be a motivational speaker. You don't need prayer. Just read some books. You don't need prayer. Just read some books. Am I speaking to somebody here?
Your weakness is your limitation. Your weakness is your limitation. Your weakness is your limitation.
A man come to you and say, God told me. Who sent you to that city? Nobody's anointing should make you lose your originality. Who sent you to that city? God. Can't you ask that same God? Nobody monopolizes a gift. Nobody has the power to monopolize a gift. God spoke to him. Okay, if God told you I should eat, let me ask him. But many of us, we are intimidated by sight. By the exteriors, the paraphernalias, and the bravado of a big name. Worshipping roles. This is a great man of God. I have sat in an aircraft for 45 minutes and I argued with a very great man of God on certain truths. I said, I don't believe this. He said, what do you mean? I have been a preacher for the past 50 years. I said, it doesn't change the Bible. The Bible is the Bible. I don't believe this. He said, what? I said, I read my Bible. I said, sir, look at the Bible. Show me that thing you said. I don't believe in it. This is not correct. I said, sir, with all due respect, I'm very ready to learn. But if I must learn, the Bible must be the standard. The Bible is older than you. I said, so show me from the Bible. He said, you don't know anything. All these young men in ministry. I said, if it's that thing you mentioned, then I don't want to know. I don't want to know. Am I speaking to somebody here? I don't want to know. You can't move with the careless and be careful. When you discuss with the old prophet, get ready for old visions. You cannot move with the careless and be careful. When you move with the careless, you'll be carefree. Who you relate with matters a lot. I wish I was talking to somebody here. I said, I wish I was talking to somebody here. I wish I was talking to somebody here. And the young man ate. Look at this. What brought him to that land? The word of the Lord. As soon as he ate, God stopped speaking. God now spoke to the old prophet. The young prophet had God. The old prophet used lies to maintain his status. I don't know if you understand me. He was not hearing God anymore. He was not using lies to maintain his status. He was maintaining being called a prophet with lies. But as soon as that man messed up, God moved back to the old prophet. This time it was God Almighty that now spoke to him. Anytime you mess up, God has a backup. When you mess up, God has a backup. Even phones and SIMs have backups. So the Almighty God has a massive backup. Anybody, I can tell you, when God is in operation, there is no vacuum. Sir, in your itinerant ministry, have you not had people who you so depended, they walked away? And you thought nobody could do anything until the next person that came did better than the person that left. The person, in fact, some people around you don't make you discover the capacity of others. It's when they are gone, you say, what? Can this person act like this? And when God wants to frustrate them, when they live proud, he makes the next person's action to humble them. I wish I was saying something here. When they live proud, it makes the person will come and do it better than them. So ladies and gentlemen, never get to a point where you say, if not me, nothing can happen. If not me, if not me, if not me, if not me, nothing can happen. I am standing here. I'm the one that's like the pillar of this walk. I'm the one like the pillar of this assignment. If not me, nothing. Am I talking to somebody here? If you mess up, God has a backup. The old prophet came. Please be careful of elder brothers. Elder brothers, be careful of elder brothers. Elder brothers were against the prodigal son. Elder brothers were against Moses, against Joseph. Elder brothers in ministry can be very dangerous. They don't see why the younger ones should write. What did the young prophet do? What was the problem? Can I shock you? The only anger he had, it was not because the young prophet came to town. It was not because the young prophet did anything. The only anger the old prophet had was as soon as they told him that the young prophet went to the king. I'm the only one who should have access to the king. How come the king has now sent for him? Come the king now relate. I'm the only one. There are people that's to show you his motive. Because he's felt as he has left the palace, the king must have given him so much. When you are materialistic, you can kill. When you are materialistic, you can kill. Pastor, God, listen to this, everybody. God spoke to a young prophet, don't eat. And he ate. A lion is not known to devour you and drop the carcass. He eats it. So God spoke to the lion, don't eat. The lion did not eat. So God spoke to a young prophet, don't eat. He ate. God spoke to a lion, don't eat. Lion didn't eat. So any man that disobeys God is not better than an animal. An animal is better than a disobedient minister. A lion refused to eat, a prophet ate. Do you know there are general overseers who can't remember? They can't remember when last they fasted. And there are people in children's church who are fasting. A general overseer, as I'm talking now, he has Fanta by his side. When I talk a little, we open it. I saw that in South Africa. I was almost crying. Reverend Kinsley, don't laugh. I was almost crying. You are ministering, somebody will take one thing and he's not writing, he's not taking notes. He will take one sniff, he will sip a little bit, drop it, and speak it out. Am I talking to somebody here? A general overseer without a personal retreat, a personal walk with God, a personal relationship with God. Am I speaking to somebody here? There are times my wife has entered my room and she look at me, my eyes are so red through the night. He said, you have not slept. I said, don't worry, it is well, it is well. He said, no, don't dispel me. Lie down. Lie down. Sleep now. And my eyes are closed. Sleep. Okay. There must be a one-on-one relationship with God. G.O. has not fasted, and children in children's church are doing retreats for their forthcoming program. They're having children meeting and children conference, and they are doing a fast. And a general overseer, not knowing that even nobody health-wise can live long when he has a voracious appetite. People that are easy, very easy to contact sugar diabetes are pastors. Because everywhere they send you to, they will give you Sprite. They will give you Coke. You finish preaching, they will pour Coke for you, pour juice for you. Pastors eat anything. Pastor will carry egg, peel it, and swallow egg, not knowing that when you eat that yolk in the egg, it can give you heart attack. When you want to eat egg, you take away that yolk. Pastors that still eat beef, you get to 40, you don't eat red meat. Ugh. Am I speaking to somebody? Don't eat pounded yam. Semo, eat yeast, wheat. When you boil rice, you boil rice and boil it, become very soft. You have boiled away all the nutrients. Am I talking to somebody here? No, this is the truth, because many pastors who we have prayed with, who have health challenge, they are terrible appetites. A pastor wake up by 2 a.m. to eat fufu. Is that not initiation? That's not eating in the dream. It's eating in real life. Eating in the dream is even better than that one. 2 a.m. You want to die? You are behaving like politicians. Not knowing those ones, they go abroad for checkup all the time. You don't go for checkup. Once you develop it, you carry anointing oil. You rub it, they say it is well. Wow. You are joking. Am I talking to somebody here? I entered a pastor's house. I saw pounded yam. And I saw okporoko, this around this thing. I saw another place. There were so many pomo by the side. And I asked him, I said, I know what fish gives. I know what meat gives. What does pomo give? No, I'm telling you, there are things that you shouldn't eat so you can live long. Am I talking to somebody here? Lots of pastors have collapsed on the altar. They'll say it was heart attack. Some others will pass out. A pastor should be surrounded more with fruits. More with what? Am I talking to somebody? And please, pastors' wives, please begin.
to make that for your husband. Get pineapple, get orange, get apples, make all that. If you can even blend them, put it in the fridge. Let him take, let his body be nourished. Am I speaking? Because he needs to be well. I have discovered when I am well rested, I perform better. When I sleep and well rested. Man of God, you see people, flocks, they will always be flocks. They are called flocks. They flock around. If you are not careful, they will make you miss God, die before your time, and as soon as you are dead, they jump on the next preacher. I used to do something before. When I finished preaching, there are people lined up after prayer, sweating. I see a few in the office. I come down. I'm almost driving off out of sympathy. I will come down from my car, start laying on some people. One day I got to the house. The Holy Spirit said, Superman, Shebi, you will die. When you die, it's this woman and the children you will leave behind. By that time, you discover that those were the only members you had. So you are seeing them, that it is wickedness, for after this kind of massive anointing, a pastor will say, you didn't touch my head. You are a demonic person. You are diabolic. Sir, when can I still see you one on one? Are you seeing me two on two now? Jesus said, I have never seen such great faith in Israel. Why? He said, don't come to my house, speak the word. That is faith. I want to see, it's not faith. Faith is send the word. Send the word. Say, don't come, don't bother. Jesus said, I have never, and I asked myself, what was the faith in this thing? The faith that rests on the word, not on the man, is the greatest faith in Israel. Others expected Jesus, come and lay their hand. Jesus said, you have faith. Others expected Jesus, come and cast out the demon. He said, you have faith. But one said, don't come. Send the word. He said, this among all the faith is the potent, greatest faith in Israel. Am I talking to somebody here? Please, as a pastor, let me say this to you. You might say, oh, you are just starting. You are just beginning. Counseling is not every day. Counseling has days, has hours. It's not every day. There are times you say, you see, today there's no counseling. I'm not counseling. I want to counsel myself. You must be refreshed, because some people get outdated. Even office is not 24 hours. There is something called office hours. If you come when it's not office hours, you will not be attended to. That is why I like some adoptions of the foreign life. When it's not time, you will stand there. They won't attend to you. They say, we open at 8 a.m. You say, but I'm here early. They say, wait, that's order. A pastor wants to pray for 3 days, and the emergency comes and carries him out of prayer closet. Somebody, a pastor was having 3-day prayer, and one leader calls, says, daddy, they pass the phone to the GO. He said, I'm in prayer. I said, I just want to tell you that the church bus broke down. So the man said, what do I do? He said, we are confused. Man of God left prayer tower. Started looking for a mechanic. And the wife called me. I said, he has left again. No. I called him. I said, where are you? He said, this is our church bus. It's becoming a problem to me. I thought you said you want to pray. He said, sir, if I don't do it, nobody will do it. Leave the bus! I said, it's better the bus break down than you break down. I've seen certain emergencies at the time. He said, sir, there is a corpse in the church. I said, let the corpse be there. There have been corpses in churches. Paul was preaching when somebody fell down and died. He went down and he prayed. He went upstairs and continued preaching. His message, he preached somebody dead. He preached the man till he died. He went there, prayed for the man. The man got back to life. I thought he was going to round up. He didn't round up. He went back up again to still preach some more dead. Continue preaching. So you must understand that your like God's servant told us yesterday, take it to thyself. How many of you discovered that some of these things are things I shared in the conference? That it is you that matters, not the people.
When you are right with God, your walk will be right in this world. People will queue up. Sir, I grew up around the late Archbishop Idahosa. And I can tell you, I saw a man of God in that man. I can tell you. When you focus on the exteriors of people, you make mistakes. That's why I tell people, do not do what people do in public until you know who they are in secret. When the Archbishop finished preaching, sir, he will stand on the altar. Altar will be crowded. Everybody wants to talk to him. Everybody wants to see him. Everybody wants to see him. When I saw that, the man died at 59. And they say God called him up. It's true. But stress, lack of rest contributed to it. I said, God, but I want to reach the people. And God said to me, make your number. My number is like a business center. Am I saying the truth? You don't need to look for it. You have it. And God said, whoever cannot send you a message and get your attention by that, don't see. Because they are look. What killed most God's generals? Some were worn out. Jacob, appetite finished him. Counseling till 9. Jacob died at 36 or 38. 38. Expired before his time. Young man, expired. Why? Because there were people surrounded who preferred themselves. My wife gave birth and somebody called me and said, Dad, you need to pray for me now. I'm not well. I said, my wife just gave birth. I'm rushing there. He said, leave your wife and baby. God will take care of that. Come and pray for me. I said, my wife just gave birth. He said, leave your wife and baby. God, you are a man of God. God will take care of your own. I need you to come and pray. And I responded, the number you have called is not available at the moment. Please don't call again. Because you are satanic. I said, my wife, you are not even rejoicing with me. Your problem matters than giving her attention. I'm showing you the wickedness of the heart of men. Some things you call counseling are nothing but draining agenda. To drain. Some will do everything last time in front of you. After the struggle. See why you here? Speak a word. You mean all the protocol you've been fighting with is to speak a word that I've been speaking from the altar. The greatest portion of every ministry is not the pastor's office, it's the altar. Whatever you want to get in a man's life, if you drop a seed and kneel down and cry to God, here is stronger than his office. But that's what people don't. That's why many ministers of God have been drained. Many of us are drained, exhausted. On Sunday, a pastor will go to the house till 8 p.m. to 7 p.m. What are you doing in the office? To 8, to 9. Some people come to the office to 12. That's when they come home. So now when I get to my come up, I say, where are you? So I say, come home now. Now me marry you, not be those members. Leave them. Alliance on you. I say, be free. You know, free. Be bound now. Will I kill myself? I have left many people who were swimming on the ground during deliverance. I left them swimming. Entered my car and drove up. Since you like to swim, keep swimming. When you finish swimming, you will stand up and dress up and go. As far as I'm concerned, I said, come out. It is left. This one you are doing now is just is acrobatic display. I've left many in the name of Jesus. They just start swimming, jumping, tumbling. I said, what is this? What is this? A young girl, during deliverance, the pastor didn't come out. And the girl went backwards on the pastor's stomach and gave him serious blow, a punch. Pastor said, Jesus! It was in Agbo. He now came to me. I said, what? He said, demon, blow me. I said, demon. He said, yes, sir. It's not be a demon. It is the girl. Go back. Correct slap. It's more blessed to give than to receive. Go back. He went backwards. Man, I'm going to hear this story. And give them in the name of Jesus. Ta, ta. The girl said, shaping a demon slap you. Why did they slap me?
Now the demon made us laugh. She was the one that punched him, not demon. If not demons slap, not they slap, you go talk. I was in, what do you call that place? We went to it. Bonnie, you saw what I did to that lady during deliverance. They said, leave me, Suleiman, I'm not going. I'm not going. I want to fight you. As you want to fight, I say, yes, I just got to protocol. They said, what? I said, beat her. She was delivered on the spot. Man of God, one protocol brother was holding her. That's how she elbowed the boy on the eyes. I look at the boy, I say, Jesus. So I told the boy, I said, come, follow me. I said, leave her. Okay. She stood. He said, yes. I want to fight. You want to fight me? He said, yes. I said, I want to fight you. I'm not going. I said, no problem. No, he said, let's fight. I'm not going. Let's fight. I said, let's fight. I said, I'm very good at that. One of the brothers, like, is a protocol from Port Harcourt. If you see slap, he was just sowing seeds on her face, just sowing seeds. Ta ta. Because it's okay. Throughout the other deliverance, she was the one correcting people that were manifesting unnecessarily. I was looking at her on the altar. I was just looking at her. She sat down. She was very humble. When they are ministering to others, you saw her. When they are ministering to others, and they're trying to say, behave well. Behave well, because she knew what entered her face. You see how many pastors in the name of deliverance have left with injuries. Don't say it was the demon. Then you respond. Your clothes are torn. Say you are doing deliverance cases. Am I speaking to somebody here? Be wise. No, where were you when they now blow you? Your eyes were closed. Bible says, watch and pray. In deliverance, you are closing eyes. Open the eyes well. I've been in a place in Abia Kuta, they call it Shakbon. Man of God, with all due respect, that is when I knew that holiness is not covering ears or covering head. You can enter that church, everybody was covering their head. I started deliverance from 6 p.m. till 4 a.m. Even pastor was under the chair. Pastor's wife was tumbling. I ministered, commanded, prayed, come out, fire. Everybody was tumbling. In Jesus' name, they have a bell. They use bell. I rang. They were still manifesting. I was looking for a pastor to give him mic. He was rolling and vomiting under the chair. So I'm not the one that possessed them. So I dropped mic, took my Bible, and went to go and sleep. Ministry is easy. Don't die before your time. See, today is the day. Whether you like it or not, you must go. Enough for today. In the name, not fling suit. Say, in the name of Jesus. Rakabayada. Today you must be delivered. And the Lord look at you. And he says, all that deliverance entails is the word. He sent his word. And his word. Let me say one more, then we'll pray. The old prophet deceived the young prophet and was the one that buried him. When you say young, old, who should die first? In that scripture, who died first? So whoever deceives you outlives you. Whoever deceives you outlives you. Whoever you allow to deceive you, outlives you. Are you ready to pray? I'm going to pray for spiritual sensitivity. Help me, Lord, to be sensitive. That when a deceiver stands around me, let me know. Among my flocks, among those I relate with, open my eye to see the deceivers planted around me. Open my eyes to see me. anoint my eyes with eye salve, that I stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Ikoporodosh. 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 Alaba. Gibi, 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 gibi. Why is there no sound on that keyboard? Keep it, 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 ke